you're able, come on out from that reindeer stable.
Well, with that grade school level poetry we heard last Monday in the war zone, Mark Merrill brings Sable to the ring. However, when we saw Sable, she didn't quite look like she usually does, JR, because Mark Merrill had seen to it she was a bit more covered up.
All the Marvelous One wants to do is humiliate Sable, but there's a problem there, and that problem is the big Italian Tom Brandi, who got involved after Merrill's victory Monday night.
Well, I got a real easy solution for Mr. Merrill. He will be the star of the show when Sable...
Oh, come on.
Oh, for good measure, a low blow when Sable runs up and leaves him because he pushes her to it, then he's going to be the star of the show. He's going to be the only member of it.
Wait a minute. Here comes Tom Brandi. Brandi on his way to the ring, and Brandy's not going to stand for this any longer. Brandi and Merrill got in that locker room brawl over the weekend. They've had quite the rivalry in the last couple of weeks, a dropkick by the big Italian.
Brandi, he's all over Merrill.
And Merrill making a U-turn. And, Merrill hit his knee in the security railing. Merrill goes down. Tom Brandi just not going to stand by and watch Marvelous Mark Merrill take advantage of any athlete, especially the light heavyweight Scott Taylor. And it looks like Merrill's his left
hand. Hey, look at Sable. She's walking away from Merrill. She turned her back on Merrill.
I don't blame her.
And she...
Oh, there she goes. Now, that's what I was telling you about earlier.
Whoa!
Now, that is Santa's little helper. What would you like for Christmas, Mr. Cornette?
I've got a list. I'm just wondering what she was helping Santa do.
I'm going to check it twice. Now, that is a... That's what you call spreading the old holiday cheer right there, folks.
Well, folks are most happy that Sable finally unveiled herself.
I would like to wish each and every one of you a very Merry Christmas.
They should fit my stocking.
As a matter of fact, I think she, along with an 18-wheeler, would fit your stocking. Well, JR, whether it be Nassau Coliseum or Madison Square Garden, when Sable gets a huge ovation, it just drives Merrill crazy. But at the Garden on January 10th, Tom Brandi goes one-on-one with Marvelous Mark. Wonder whose side Sable will be on.
That's a good question. We'll find out on January the 10th in the Garden.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. About to enter the ring from Downingtown, Pennsylvania, weighing 262 pounds, Tom Brandi.
Tom Brandi, the big Italian, has a wonderful opportunity on January the 10th in Madison Square Garden. And Barry Houston being introduced for the first time here on WWF New York. You know, a lot of folks, I think, thought that Brandi, better known in some circles as Sal Sincere, was going to be relegated to preliminary status his entire career in the WWF. But I tell you, James Z, that may not be.
Well, I think that Brandi thought that by adopting this Sal Sincere persona that it would get him some attention, some notoriety in the WWF, but it only worked against him because he wasn't being himself. And ever since that Merrill caused this controversy and Brandi dropped that Sal Sincere name and that whole silly Italian mess and concentrated on being Tom Brandi, he is undefeated in the WWF.
Well, he is Italian, you know.
He is Italian, but...
Nothing wrong with that.
He doesn't wear a big floppy hat and he doesn't say, I love you all and all that other stuff. He gets in there. He's a big 6'3", 275-pounder, and he wins matches. He's a veteran. He's got about 10 years of experience. He's a good-looking athlete. And I'm a big fan of Tom Brandi's. I wasn't of Sal Sincere's.
Well, apparently Sable's a pretty big fan of Tom Brandi as well. And, of course, Sable and Sonny in the special double cover edition of the Raw magazine. Now, folks, you want to talk about a swimsuit edition of a magazine, let me tell you, this is something special. And it's going to be available this Tuesday at newsstands everywhere.
Two collector's covers. I don't know why they call it a double cover, because I think they're only half cover.
Or less, but in any event, Barry Houston trying to mount some sort of offense here. And thus far, it's been too strong, too much power by Tom Brandi, but there's a knockdown by Barry Houston. And Houston's got a lot of quickness corkscrew elbow on Brandi.
Houston's a good-looking athlete, but I think if he was very tough, he would have already been in jail for murdering the guy that gave him that haircut.
Well, I tell you what, you talk about tough. This Monday night on Raw, folks, if you can't be with us in the Nassau Coliseum, tune your TV sets to the USA Network and be with us live. You're going to see one of the most raucous, enthusiastic crowds that you will ever see, because they are great in the Nassau Coliseum for Live Raw Is War.
You think there's going to be some signs there? Maybe people chanting? Some people screaming? Some people yelling?
Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley defending the newly won European title against Owen Hart. I can't wait to see what kind of ovation Owen Hart gets when he meets Triple H this Monday night on Raw.
Watch Brandi.
Good cross body. That's a nice move by the big man, leaving his feet. Brandi has everything, seemingly anyway, under control here.
He has been at a steady pace. He hasn't exerted himself. The only offense that Houston has really gotten in that damaged Brandi was when he's gone to the eyes a couple of times. You can't work the eyes out on an eye machine in the gym. But Brandi has really got Houston under control.
High back body drop there. Well, I'll tell you what, folks, I can remember the first time that I walked into Madison Square Garden for my first WWF event. As far as broadcasting was concerned, it was the greatest thrill of my career. And you got to believe that Tom Brandi has some of those same butterflies, because he's got to be knowing that on January the 10th, he's got an opportunity to make a name for himself, to be somebody in Madison Square Garden. And let's don't kid ourselves, that's where it counts.
Well, the greatest thrill of my career involving Madison Square Garden was the first time I went the cab ride on the way to the arena. That was a thrill. It was death-defying.
Brandi sent to the ropes. Houston misses the clothesline. Look out here.
Whoop.
Full Nelson. Into a slam. Oh, you can almost feel the air drive right out of the body of Barry Houston. And a very convincing victory for Tom Brandi.
He covered the man with authority. And I think that's the same thing that he's going to do to Mark Merrill on January 10th at the Garden.
That is, unless Merrill is able to execute his patented galata.
We'll take another look at how Brandi won this one. Swing and a miss. Swing and a block. Hooked up the Full Nelson.
Boom.
And boom, the back of his head right on the mat. Brandi wins.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, he's 415 pounds. He is Olympian Mark Henry, the world's strongest man, will join us when we come back.
He dunks, too.